Wake up! Wake up! Wake up, wake up. It's time to rise and sing the praise of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
It's time to rise,
to sing, to shout, to bring him all your heart. He'll do the bigger part if you will only make a start. It's time to give him all your heart, and only you can make a start.
Wake up!
The Chosen 12 was never randomly selected by Jesus Christ when he was looking for his workmates here on earth to accompany him in his ministry. The Chosen 12 was gathered with a reason and with a purpose. When the 12 was completed, they were called the disciples. This is the very reason why we need to know the life of each of these individuals that God wanted us to uncover more in our inspirational devotionals. Every day, we will be uncovering one disciple by means of discovering one very important virtue they possessed. Until we will complete the 12, we will then discover the greatest reason why God called these individuals so that we can structure also our lives patterned through these exemplary apostles. With this, we can aspire to be God's ministers, missionaries, evangelists, and most of all, God's disciples in our own simple and practical ways. So it's time to discover who will be our disciple of the day. Fasten your seatbelts as we journey through the chosen ones in our 7 Minutes with God inspirational devotionals. This is still Brother Noy Gonzaga serving as God's mouthpiece.
Simon Peter, Andrew, James, his brother John.
Let us first condition our souls with the gem located in James 4 verse 6, and it says, God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble. Friends, Apostle James, the son of Alpheus, referred to as James Alpheus, is frequently called by Bible hierarchical society as James the Lesser. This is in connection to another James in the Bible, who is James Zebedee, who is in the inner circle of God, considered as James the Greater. So do not be confused. We will be talking about James Alpheus or James the Lesser. When James was asked to follow Jesus, he did not say no because of one great observation. James Alpheus saw that Jesus is a God of simplicity. He admired the simplicity of the Master. He could not comprehend the mind of Jesus, but he did grasp the sympathetic bond between himself and the heart of their master. His mind was not of a high order. Yet, he might even reverently be called stupid, but he had a great experience with Jesus that really molded his personality. If there is one disciple that reflected and embedded the humility of the master, that can never be anyone but James the Lesser. Let me uncover the importance of the role of Apostle James Alpheus by sharing with you a story. One day, the mouth questioned the whole body. Is there any of you here who might think you are better than me? Then the nose said, I guess I am. Because if I will not breathe, all of you will die. The nose did not function, but the mouth managed to replace the nose at the moment. Meaning, it is not the nose. So the mouth said, maybe if I will not eat, all of you will starve and die. That makes me the greatest here. So the mouth quit eating. But instantly, the nose pulled out a nasogastric tube, otherwise known as NGT, and started putting it inside the nose and then eat with it. And they all survived. Next, it was the hands to brug, then the feet, then the ears, then every part of the body make themselves known. But to no avail. Not so long from that moment, an irritated member of the body came up and said, would you all care to shut up? I know all of you are important, and I am not as important as any of you. The fact that I am hidden and you are all shown. but not me. Well, who really would care for an anus like me? But if you want to know how important other parts of the body can be, then starting today, I will not pass out stool anymore. I will not pass out dirt anymore. Everybody laughed. Imagine an anus threatening the greater parts of the body. It's just like an ant threatening an elephant. However, as the days passed, defecation did not happen, and poison contaminated the body, making everyone feel dizzy and uncomfortable. Later, the effect is just debilitating that all of them, all of the parts of the body, pleaded for the anus to pass out stool, recognizing that it is not who is more important in the body, but rather knowing what will happen when a part of the body is not functioning. Yes, like the human body, like the anus, you may not be that important, but when you will not function, everybody will suffer. Again, yes, it's like the human body. Other disciples are so visible, are so great, but James the Lesser may not be seen often, but when he is not there, the group will always feel crippled. James Alpheus is a good-natured, simple-minded helper, and everybody loved him. Take note, everybody liked him. Jesus welcomed this young man who only has one talent, and that is to be very willing in whatever will be requested to him. Well, Jesus welcomed this young man who, he said, has one talent to a position of honor on his personal staff in the kingdom because there are untold millions of other such simple and fear-ridden souls in the world or in this world. It might be you, it might be me. That's why Jesus put one there so that we will not be discouraged because we have a model there. Jesus do not look down upon littleness, only upon evil and sin. James was little but was so faithful. He was simple and ignorant, but he was also big-hearted, kind, generous, and always willing. Take note, always willing. Earlier, we mentioned that the absence of James Alpheus is always noticeable even if he is not a prominent person in the physical and actual presentation of the mission. To be short, he is not very prominent in that chosen 12. Like today, James is a behind-the-curtain worker, behind-the-scene actor. He does the dirty work, such as carpentry for the meetings, washing of the dishes if necessary, and clearing of the roads if the master needs a little comfort. Other disciples have their entrusted responsibilities, and we know that. Judas Iscariot is the treasurer, but it is James Alpheus that is doing the actual marketing for Judas. Peter is the spokesperson of the group, but it is James Alpheus who carried the notes, messages, and other communications that Peter wanted the people to know. In short, James is always a part of all the committees of the famous disciple, and he is there as a member and an endline implementer, meaning he is the errand boy of all the other well-known disciples, but it did not distract him. It did not matter to him as long as he will be near to Jesus. James did not feel less because he knew that he is doing this for Jesus. James did not feel disrespected either because he knew that the human mind can be carnal and Christ's mind is more open and divine. James Alpheus showed to the world that the work is not only what people can see. What can make leaders become famous? There are little things that needs to be done even if unnoticed. But these little things are the ones that really create the difference, and these are very visible to the eyes of the Lord, even if not to our fellow human beings. One thing that James the Lesser, or James Alpheus, of the 12 disciples, he may not have the highest rank. He may have only clerical work to settle with. He may not have administrative privileges. But when the day comes when Jesus reappeared to the disciples, the first disciple to recognize and believe that it was Jesus who came back from death is no other than James Alpheus, or James the Lesser. Yes, what good it can be if we have the highest positions in our organization, the greatest connections in our system, the broad influences in the institution, or even the imagination of being the greatest leader in our society. Yet, when the day comes when the Savior passed by, not wearing his heavenly and kingly robe, we may not even notice the Savior because our visions are dimmed with pride, prejudice, possession, positions, and professions. James does not have any of this. James do not have any of them. But when the day Jesus returned, or the day Jesus was risen from the dead and returned to them, he was the first to recognize and believe the Master. Are we also becoming more religiously blind because of our pride, prejudice, possessions, positions, and profession? Well, in like manner, are you ready to leave them if Jesus will say, "Leave everything and let us be fishers of men"? Well, nothing is sure. No one is sure. But James the willing apostle is always very sure, and he will always and surely be our greatest model for knowing the Master more, for knowing the Master in a simple way. At this moment, join me, dear friends. We will offer a prayer for God's guidance as we emulate the willing attitude in the exemplary life of Apostle James the Lesser.
Our loving and simple but divine Master Jesus Christ, this moment, Lord, with humble hearts, simple dispositions, and willingness of the Spirit, we come to Thee to be used in Your mission. Lord, we know that even if we are just mere humans, we can always do great for Thy work here on earth. We know, Lord, it is never the greatness of the responsibility that will be assigned to us, but rather it is how effective we are in our assignments, even if that is not that great, but greatly done in Your blessed name, Jesus Christ. Lord, it is our greatest hope that You will use ordinary people like us extraordinarily. For wherever the Lord is, we are always promised with success and abundance. This moment, Lord, we consecrate our lives to You. Thy will be done, Lord. Amen.
I hope and pray that you have gained a valuable lesson from the life of the disciple that we have tackled at this moment. This is James Alpheus, or James the Lesser, a humble passerby, a nobody, an unnoticed member of the team. But sometimes, it is those persons whose heart is worth immutable, especially if they are always willing and greatly useful in the organization of Christ's missions and itineraries when He was still here on earth. Join us again next time as we will uncover the rest of the 12 disciples of Jesus Christ and their exemplary values, which could have been the very reason why God called them to walk with Him and be fishers of men. This is the 7 Minutes with God today. And this is still Brother Noy Gonzaga, your online inspirational evangelist, saying, when we do our best academically, intellectually, and professionally, but we will not put God first and we are not willing to put our pride down, then it is useless. Our willingness will always be the greatest disposition in our life as we participate more in the evangelism of this world. God's will be done. Amen.
Wake up, it's time to rise and sing the praise of Jesus. Alleluia, alleluia.
It's time to rise,
to shout, to bring Him all your heart.
He'll do the bigger part
if you will only make a start.
Wake up! Wake up!